Welcome to the video tutorial on how to install and configure NextCloud on Windows. Here are the installation instructions on the NextCloud homepage. You can install NextCloud on Windows 10 and 11. Your computer requires a minimum of 8 GB of RAM and 4 cores. Let's get started. First, you install Docker for Windows. You download and install Docker for Windows. After completing the installation, you are asked to restart Windows. Here are some basic setups after completing the Docker installation. Before installing NextCloud, create a domain name for yourself to access from anywhere. I recommend using DuckDNS because it's free. DuckDNS not only gives you a free domain name but also helps you update your public IP address dynamically. You create a new domain name and install the DuckDNS client software on your Windows computer. This software requires a computer with Java installed. DuckDNS client helps you update your public IP address every time it changes. So the public IP address is always mapped to your domain name. The public IP address has been updated successfully. Next, you forward the port on the router. This is my router. Before forwarding ports on the router, set up a static IP address for your Windows computer. This is the IP address I assigned to my Windows computer. You use this IP address to forward ports on the router. On the router, forward port 443 to the IP address assigned to the Windows computer in the previous step. You need to make sure to complete the domain name creation and port forwarding on the router before installing NextCloud. Next, open the command window on Windows and start installing NextCloud. This is the code used to install NextCloud, and I want to customize it a bit. By default, data is stored on Windows C partition. To increase the size, I store data on Windows D partition. In this case, I create a cloud with a size of 1 TB. Instead of storing on partition C, I store on partition D. Now you just need to copy and paste the code into the command window and wait a moment to complete. After completing the installation, access NextCloud with port 8080. These are the steps to install NextCloud for first use. You copy and paste the password as above. Next, you set up the domain name that was prepared in the previous step. Make sure to forward port 443 on your router. This is the domain name I created in the previous step. Free domain name from DuckDNS service. These are some default software when installing NextCloud. You can leave them as default if you want. I will remove some software to speed up NextCloud. Scroll down and set the time zone. After completing the basic settings, click Download and Start Containers. There are several services starting, so you wait until they are all running. All services are running. This is your NextCloud username and password. You log into NextCloud with the initial account. So I have completed installing NextCloud on Windows 11. Next, I upload a random file to test my cloud. This is my cloud storage capacity, about 900 plus GB, much larger than free cloud services. The data is stored in partition D of Windows as mentioned in the previous step. If you want to increase the storage size, replace it with a larger hard drive. I recommend that you change the default password because it is long and difficult to remember. On NextCloud, I created a new account for remote access. These are the basic steps to install and configure NextCloud on Windows. I use an Android phone to connect to the cloud server. I use this to access NextCloud from anywhere. On my Android phone, I installed the NextCloud application and accessed the server using the domain name set up in the previous step. I then used the newly created account to log into NextCloud. Logged in successfully. You allow NextCloud to access data on your Android phone to upload files to the cloud server. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I uploaded a random file to test the connection between my Android phone and the NextCloud server. Wishing you successful installation of NextCloud on your Windows computer. Uploaded successfully.